Happy birthday, Mr. President. Like that, but like... Hello, and welcome to another episode of Intoxicated. I am your host, Kate Comedy. Today, we will be discussing President's Day. According to the federal government, when we celebrate President's Day, we're actually celebrating George Washington's birthday. And George Washington was actually born on February 22nd. In 1968, Congress actually passed a law called the Uniform Monday Holiday Act, which changed George Washington's birthday from the 22nd to always fall on the third Monday of February. So like, if you fucking hate your birthday, just call up your local congressman. They'll put in a notice for you and they might be able to change your fucking birthday, apparently. Dead or alive, they can do that. I can only imagine that like George Washington would be like, that's not my fucking birthday, that's weird. Or maybe he was like really like conceited and was like, hell yeah. Hell yeah, you never forget the first. Also, in 1968, the reason for them changing his birthday was to give Americans a 3-day weekend. Americans love a fucking long ass weekend, for sure. They would shut down, no mail, no banks are closed, schools, you have a day off on President's Day, only valid in states that recognize that it is not federally known. Abraham Lincoln also was born in February, so in the 70s, we opened it up to celebrating George Washington's birthday and Lincoln's birthday. Abraham Lincoln was born on February 12th, and again, Washington 22nd. So they merged the two presidents. And in this ideal, they were like the best presidents, you know, the old timey presidents that did first and the 16th. They were like, yeah, we'll just force them together. And it was just like calling the date President's Day just like worked really well with like selling it on people, selling it on the American people, but also selling it in marketing. President's Day sale. You didn't hear, we have the George Washington annual sale. No, President's Day sale, get a new couch. William Henry Harrison and Ronald Reagan also have birthdays in February, but who gives a fuck? Lincoln and Washington forever. Some states will celebrate all the presidents, just all of them. Some states will only celebrate George Washington. Some states only celebrate Washington and Lincoln. And there are some states that only celebrate the idea of being president, which somehow still isn't the same as celebrating all presidents. Arkansas celebrates George Washington's birthday and Daisy Gadsden Bates' birthday. And Daisy Gadsden Bates was a civil rights activist and president of the NAACP, baby. Good for you, Arkansas. Fucking, after all, it's fucking Black History Month. We have all of these fucking made up holidays that definitely white people came up with. They're all made up and they placed them in February. Like, starting out, number one, Groundhog's Day. That's make-believe. Number two, we have Valentine's Day. And number three, let's just like, President's Day, okay? We as a country still can't agree if it's this guy's birthday or that guy's birthday, or we're celebrating all the presidents or like just some of them, or like just the idea of the Oval Office. It's nuts. It's made up. Leave it alone. It's Black History Month. Leave February out of your fucking make-believe shenanigans, because you're making people insane. You're making people question a lot of things. Start questioning, guys. These are questions that you need to be asking. Where I grew up, the state that I grew up, they were like, okay, we celebrate all presidents. That's how I, like, you know, that's why I'm so well-versed in presidents, you know? I have fun here. This year, I decided for President's Day, I would take a fun little poll with my gal friends, and I asked them what presidents they would have been. They can be young or old in these scenarios, Republican or Democratic. I asked them to throw all of those worries out the window, because this is just like the holiday, a made-up poll that I decided to do. I told them to take out the obvious bangs. That would be Barack Obama. Like a fine glass of wine. He's out. Bill Clinton, sorry. You and your saxophone can wait off stage. And JFK. We'd all want to be Jackie O. We all want to be Marilyn, okay? So I took those three men off the table because those are obviouses. And I asked my friends to come up with some presidents that they would bang. And I also included myself. So first up on the list, and there's no particular order of this at all either, George W. Bush. In his college years though, specifically in his college years, because we would totally party with that frat boy. Abraham Lincoln, quote, because he wasn't like that ugly. And then I said, hell yeah, I would climb Abe like a fucking tree. Climb him like a tree. My boy Ulysses S. Grant, when he served in the Civil War. We have Nixon, because he had menacing eyes. And then I put, personally, I would take a ride on Teddy Roosevelt's mustache. And I hope that it's in a national park that he established. Oh, young FDR. He was a big, like, agreement, unanimous. Young FDR, young Franklin Delano Roosevelt could get it. He could get it. I also said that I would have taken him for a spin even when he was wheelchair bound, because he started unemployment, which I am forever and always grateful for, especially after the year that I had in 2020. That one's for FDR. We had young Reagan because, duh, he was like a movie star. William Howard Taft because he had a full beard, and I'm a beard kind of gal. The last one was Washington because, duh, he's first. And the other argument was, it's his birthday. And who doesn't like birthday sex? You know what? Who doesn't? Birthday sex, Washington gets it. Washington makes the cut. Happy President's Day, everybody. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.